Hey YouTube, what's up? It's Tony. Just thought I'd make a video because there's been something on my mind lately. I've been talking to some friends here on YouTube and various places on the internet about some pretty crazy shit, junk. Excuse me, I do tend to cuss when I get agitated. Some pretty crazy stuff that's been going on in the world today. As far as is government control and gun control issues and a wide variety of things like this. And I hate to say it, but it's a sign of the times what we live in these days. In this day and time, we've got all these advances. We've got radio, we've got television, we've got the internet, we've got Wi-Fi going all the time, we've got satellite radio, we've got telephones, we've got cell phones, we've got all this technological equipment, and even in warfare, we've got guns and machine guns and guns with knives on them and all this, other stuff. And but the thing that bothers me is, even though we have all this great technology and great wonderful technology, we are stupid. Yeah, we are a stupid people. And you know why we're stupid people? Because we don't know how to learn anymore. We don't know how to think for ourselves. We don't know how to constructively make an argument. We're so caught up in ourselves and me, 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 what's right for me and not right for you. We're stuck in this me, 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 oh, I gotta get on the internet and look up pictures of Snooki. We're becoming a stupid people. All over the world, we're becoming a stupid people. And you know why? One of the reasons why I think that we're becoming a stupid people is because in school, in high school, in elementary school, in middle school, in these state-controlled schools that are out in the world today, public school, they're not teaching you how to think correctly. They're just routing off this stuff that they want you to know. And if you have a follow-up question or something, like, no, you don't need to be asking that stuff. That's not important. That's not important of the situation. You just need to learn what I'm telling you. And nobody knows how to critically think anymore. I'm gonna put a link down here at the bottom about critical thinking and what critical thinking is. Now I'm gonna read a little bit about what critical thinking is. According to this website, critical thinking is the ability to think clearly and rationally. It includes the ability to engage in reflective and independent thinking. Someone with critical thinking skills is able to do the following: understand the logical connections between ideas. No, we don't think about other ideas in this culture or any other culture. We just told by the teacher or told by whoever's telling us, this is what right and this is what you need to believe. Don't question anything else. Critical thinker also has the ability to identify, construct, and evaluate arguments. No, we don't evaluate arguments. You know what we do? We pick up a gun and pop each other in the knees if we want to, if we have a dispute. Or we pick up our fist and we don't. Or we go on the internet like little bitty trolls and make all these little comments. You're a stupid idiot. Oh, well, you're a dumb a-hole and all this stuff. Nobody has debates anymore. And if they are debates, it's all one-sided. It's there's no identifying the problem and constructing a solution to it. The critical thinker has the ability to detect inconsistencies and common mistakes in reasoning. Well, no, we don't do that anymore, just because of the reason I said. Everyone has the mentality of what I say goes, and that's the only way you need to think about things. Critical thinker has the ability to solve problems systematically. What that means is there were the A, B, C, D, E, F, G step. Think about it in a logical process, like a little system, and come to a conclusion, or the best conclusion that can be made in the possibility. We don't think logically anymore. We don't think systematically anymore. We just, oh, we, yeah, we'll go to the internet. No, you don't go to the internet. You go to the internet and look up pictures of porn. That's what you do. Or you go to the internet and look up pictures of what the sports team's doing, or who said what on Twitter, or who said what on Facebook, or whatever you wanna do. You don't use the internet as a powerful tool to learn and to research things that you really need to know, because we're too busy with these other stupid stuff. It also says the critical thinker has the ability to identify the relevance and importance of ideas. Now, in that sentence, I think that the word new should have been put in there. New, NEW. To identify the relevance and importance of new ideas. Well, that's how we grow. That's how we develop. That's how things get progress. That's, you take upon old ideas and you build upon them. Nobody does that anymore. We just sit back, oh, because such and such told me so, and so therefore it's correct. It's stupid. The last one says here, the critical thinker has the ability to reflect on the justification of one's own beliefs and or values. No, nobody has beliefs and values anymore, or nobody wants to accept that they have beliefs and values anymore. We're just, crazy watching all this stuff on the boob tube, and entertained by our little Android games, and not to say that there's anything wrong with some of that stuff. There's a time and a place for that stuff, but we have become a spoiled people. All over the world, we've become a spoiled people. Not just here in North America and in the 48 states, but all over the world, we have become a spoiled people because we don't know how to farm anymore. And if we do know how to farm, we don't know how to do it properly. We're getting the government involved in that, and then here they are putting all this genetically modified junk in our foods, and then next thing you know, some group out there is going to be telling you, "Hey, we got a perfect idea. We're going to put this little microchip in your hand, or this little microchip in your head, and it's going to do all the thinking for you because we're going to be the ones to tell you how to do all this stuff." And I'm fed up with it. I really am. I'm fed up with it. And we as a people need to really start looking back at our history, our culture, different cultures, how we are different people. And I just it's appalling to me that we're becoming a nation of mindless slaves, mindless, dumb slaves. who are being told what to do and how to do it and why to do it and when to do it and what and all this. And I just want you to think. I really want you to think about what I have said as far as where we are in 2013 and what we have and what we could do with what we have and what we are doing with what we have and how we think today. Nobody thinks in a logical manner anymore. And that's upsetting to me. And so that's pretty much my viewpoint. Go and take a look at this link that I'm gonna provide for you, and really start to think about, do I think critically? Do I think in a logical manner? Do I incorporate my beliefs and also the beliefs of others in my thinking, or am I just doing what the great and almighty television tells me, or what I'm seeing on the front page of Google Plus or YouTube or Yahoo or whatever. So that's my rant, and I'm gonna stop. So I'll see everybody later. Bye.